That's one thing to just build a device that monitors EEG and other types of signals during sleep, but the ability to take those signals, understand them, and actually modify a night of sleep on the same device, that is another big thing that we're bringing to the market.
We're now able to kind of think about engineering our sleep. We can put all of this into one package, do everything on board, and open up a whole new world.
Sleep, kind of in some ways, is one of the big final frontiers of neuroscience.
Turns out that one of the many functions of sleep is to activate clearance of waste metabolites and all kinds of nasty stuff. This is called glymphatic clearance.
When sleep quality is poor, glymphatic clearance can be disrupted. Waste metabolites can build up, which has been linked to neurological conditions such as Alzheimer's disease, dementia, and even cognitive decline in healthy aging.
The exciting thing is that we actually have a good idea of how to interact with this system.
Innovators at Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Lab have developed the system to augment restorative sleep, or STARS. They have developed a small, wearable device that rests on users' foreheads during sleep. On board is a powerful AI platform that tracks and decodes sleep in real time.
This is a closed-loop system that not only acquires sleep data, but then goes that next step, which is to analyze and then feed back to the individual to promote deep sleep.
EEG is one of our primary tools for looking at sleep and neural signals.
Convolutional neural networks and sequence modeling on the device track these EEG frequencies in real time, looking for changes in the spectral content to determine patterns and progression through sleep stages.
The same way a sleep technician is able to look at a recording of sleep and identify elements in the signal, these convolutional networks are extremely adept at doing exactly the same thing. Sequence modeling takes the output of this CNN, all the little things that it picks up on, and then keeps a memory of where your sleep has come from and how it's likely to evolve next. And when you put those two very powerful independent mechanisms together, you have something that really is more than the sum of its parts.
This combination moves beyond sleep tracking. As the AI processes your sleep signals, the system is able to react and respond to your sleep.
When we detect that you're in a particular phase of sleep, we have the ability to very quickly and rapidly, within the order of a few milliseconds, turn around and deliver stimuli or change environmental parameters to try to induce a deeper sleep and keep you in refreshing sleep for longer. One of the things we might want to react to, for example, is a slow wave of sleep.
Glymphatic clearance is driven by slow wave sleep. It's the one that makes you feel better in the morning.
We would be able to detect that, and then very quickly, within 10 milliseconds or so, elicit a beep stimulus or flash an LED or change the environment of the room in some way to hopefully entrain the next one of those.
These interventions, if timed correctly, encourage additional slow waves. More time spent in slow wave sleep means more effective glymphatic clearance and better health outcomes.
If we can entrain that stage of sleep for longer, we can get the flushing that would occur over the course of an 8-hour night of sleep, potentially in less time, potentially compressing sleep.
The system allows for what could be a new standard, not just in sleep measurement, but also in care.
You know, wakeful health and sleep health are basically two sides of the same coin, and this project will be bringing them both together.
So we know that slow wave sleep deficiency is associated with aging and other diseases. As older adults lose slow wave sleep, we know that slow wave sleep is really important for clearing neurotoxins in the brain. And so if we can potentiate slow wave sleep, we can potentially help people have healthier brains.
The platform has been built to leave room for a wide range of potential integrations, from device form factor to other wearables to new discoveries in sleep interventions.
This could really open up that bottleneck for an operating sleep clinic. Populations in rural areas, it's not easy for them to get to a sleep lab, but it sure is easy to slap one of these things in an envelope and mail it out to them.
The real value of what we've developed is in the ecosystem. We have algorithms, technologies, neural networks, and know-how. We can actually put something together that is the sleep monitoring device of our dreams.